Ask 10 different people the best way to barbecue ribs, and you'll get 10 different answers. But everyone will agree on one thing. Tender, succulent, mouth-watering meat with a flavorful caramelized crust is barbecue delight. We'll show you one simple way to prepare barbecued ribs using your gas or charcoal grill. Step 1. Choose your ribs. Pork ribs come as baby backs and spare ribs. Plan on about 1 pound per person for either kind. Baby back ribs are cut from higher on the pig, near the tenderloin. They're leaner, meatier, and cook a little faster than spare ribs, but you'll pay more per pound. Spare ribs are cut from the lower belly side of the pig. They're fattier and less meaty than baby backs, but their lower cost makes them more affordable when you're cooking for a crowd. Spare ribs will cook more evenly if they're trimmed, so cut off the skirt or flap that hangs down on the bone side of the rack and trim any excess cartilage, bones, or fat above the actual rib section. On the flip side of the ribs, you'll see a thin membrane covering the bones. Removing this membrane may allow seasonings to better soak into the meat, so work up an edge with a spoon or blunt knife. Get a good grip and peel it up in one long strip. Step 2. Rub on the flavor. A dry rub is an easy way to give ribs a flavor boost before they hit the heat. Mix 1 tablespoon each of cumin, chili powder, and paprika together in a bowl. Add some salt and pepper to taste, and you have a simple, tasty rub. Pat the ribs dry with paper towels, then sprinkle both sides generously with the dry rub. Store leftover rub in an airtight container for the next time you barbecue. Let the ribs sit with the dry rub for 30 minutes to overnight in the fridge, allowing the seasonings to penetrate the meat. Step 3. Prep the grill. Ribs are mostly bone and muscle, so cooking them slowly is the ideal method for juicy, tender, fall-off-the-bone meat. Preheat your gas grill on high for 10 minutes with the cover on. If you're using charcoal, fire it up till there's a good coat of ash. When the grill is heated, clean the grates with a wire brush and then wipe with oil to keep the ribs from sticking. Indirect heat is the best way to slow cook ribs. On your gas grill, turn off your center burner and set the side burners to medium-low. On a charcoal grill, move the hot coals off to one side. To prevent flare-ups, put an aluminum drip pan right beneath the ribs. Step 4. Slow cook the ribs. Place the ribs bone side down on the grate over the drip pan. If you're cooking several racks at a time, line them up in a rib rack. Close the grill lid and let the low heat do the rest. You'll be tempted to sneak a peek at your ribs, but try not to open the cover more than once or twice an hour. After an hour, use an instant read thermometer to check the internal temperature. Stick the probe between the ribs, avoiding the bones. Ribs need to cook to an internal temperature of at least 160 degrees Fahrenheit. If you're cooking baby back ribs, which cook faster than spare ribs, look for doneness clues, like the meat slicing easily away from the bone. Step 5. Get saucy. Wait until the last 30 minutes to slather on some barbecue sauce for the final flavor boost. Applying the sauce at the end keeps it from scorching in the heat. You don't want blackened ribs. When your ribs are cooked and sauced, use a pair of tongs to pluck them off the grill and set them on a clean cutting board.
Yeah, we get the idea. Thank you very much. This is for all my Facebook buddies out there who have not yet taken the plunge to barbecue grilling ribs.
You can start to add your own tweaks to the process.
The season is fast upon us. Never really left. Anyways, enjoy.